girl Sandy, and you already know what time it is. Y'all saw by the title, we got Real Housewives of Atlanta going on, and yeah, I'm a little tardy for the party as par usual, but I do have a good excuse. My black ass was sick, and I was in LA, so I haven't been here for the last couple of weeks, but we gonna go ahead and get it in, because you already know how we do round up in here. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, first up, we gonna go ahead and talk about this whole Phaedra, Apollo, and Kenya situation, okay? So we gonna go a couple episodes back to the situation regarding the donkey booty versus the stallion booty. Okay, first and foremost, there should not be any kind of verses in this type of situation, because I'm gonna tell you this. Can you use a shady mother sucker? How you gonna secure something for Phaedra and Apollo? Go ahead and get a cash deal on the table. Go through whatever extra work you done went through so you could possibly get whatever money on the back end. And because they decided to say no instead of pursuing it further, or maybe even trying to find another client that would have taken the cash deal to do some kind of workout tape, or even coming up with another type of workout tape to do for your damn self, you gonna go ahead and do whatever the hell they do and just change the name. That's some shady ass shit, if you ask me. That's some bull tish. And the reality is, Phaedra and Apollo, I would think with Phaedra being a lawyer, she'd have covered her black ass just a little bit better by maybe having some kind of agreement, confidentiality, whatever the case. I know it was on the cameras or whatever, but they should have had her sign some kind of waiver so that she couldn't give the idea to somebody else. That's just me. I ain't no damn lawyer. I'm just saying. All right, so now we got donkey booty, we got stallion booty, everything's in full swing. Moving on to the next episode, we show Kenya trying to get ready, getting her workout on to get ready to do her stallion booty, and trying to justify to every mother sucker that what she's doing is the right thing to do. On the other hand, we got Phaedra and Apollo doing some bootleg ass photo shoot for the damn donkey booty tape. That brings me to three questions. Three questions, y'all. Three questions for Phaedra and Apollo. One, what the hell kind of leotard was that? That green neon ass leotard? Who in the hell left the gate open? Two, why the hell would Apollo think it's appropriate to go ahead and bend Phaedra over for the photo shoot? Ain't nobody trying to see that? Three, have y'all ever seen Phaedra work out on this show? Ever. That might be a problem. I'm gonna need you to have worked out at some point, because y'all know that booty didn't come from working out. That shit was genetics. Let's be real about that. We're gonna go ahead and move on to Cynthia, all right? Who's been doing a little shit starting, but you know, we gonna get into that later on. I'm sure it's gonna come up in another couple episodes, but she, you know, she's been trying to keep herself relevant. Doing a good job, Cynthia. A-okay. Now she's trying to get into the pageantry stuff, which I totally agree with. I think it's a great industry. When I say that, I mean a money-making industry. I've done them. Them things are expensive as all hell. So, hey, good looking out on that. But Portia as your assistant? For real? Come on now. Bitch, bye. Portia ain't assisting nobody. She needs to assess herself to some damn
yams. Them yams.
All right, moving on. We gonna go to when Kenya and Portia actually had a conversation. They done went to lunch, and Kenya gonna talk about some, hey, can you go ahead and get rid of the knives at the table? Then the bitch ain't gonna let nobody get a word in edgewise. I thought y'all were supposed to communicate, and when you communicate, that means two people are gonna be having a conversation. It's reciprocal, but you know, it's whatever. It's Kenya. So she starts running off at the mouth, and I ain't even gonna lie to you. Portia actually made complete and utter sense. It's probably the smartest she's ever sounded the entire time she's been on the damn show. This girl was like,
I can only be a pawn if I allow myself to be.
That is the most intelligent shit she done said. That and,
you were done with me. I was done with you with your assy feet.
Go on, Portia. And if Candy says one more time she done bought her house with cash, I'ma throw my damn television out the damn window. Y'all already know. We gotta go into the whole Kenya coming in with Miss Lawrence situation at that charity event. Okay, first of all, Kenya, I'ma need you to have a little bit of class. Weren't you Miss USA, Miss whatever the hell? You were somebody with some kind of class at some point, or at least you were supposed to be. Your ass come out bare ass cheeks with whatever the kind booty pads on your ass with Miss Lawrence showing up at a charity event to clown Phaedra. Let's talk about this for a minute. Wouldn't you think it'd be appropriate, if you gonna go ahead and clown on Phaedra, why wouldn't you choose an event that Phaedra's having? You gonna show up at Nene's event, and you supposed to be dogs. That's supposed to be your ace boon. You done gave a girl furniture for her to move to put her in her house in LA. But you gonna show up at her charity event to talk a bunch of smack on Phaedra, cussing like a mother sucker. Really, Kenya? She gonna come out in the damn charity event with her ass cheeks out, booty pads and all, talking about some,
I'm such an alcoholic.
Girl, bye. And the booty pads, didn't they look like some pancakes? Like, I straight up wanted to spread maple syrup on them mugs. I'm just saying. Then her ass is gonna sit there, cuss everybody out. Go ahead and cuss out Phaedra, talking about some, your body looks like shit. You shouldn't have been doing a workout video anyway. Bitch, bye. Were you not the one trying to hustle around, trying to get her a workout deal in the first damn place? If you weren't even a part of that or didn't want to be a part of that, I thought she shouldn't have a part of it. Why would you go out your way to go ahead and get a deal for the girl? I mean, let's be real. It's a little hypocritical, right? But Kenya's cakes, though. I need to talk about the cakes. Y'all know I ain't got no damn ass. So I am very obsessed with cakes. Her booty cheeks. Are they real? Do y'all think that them motherfuckers are real? I really looked hard. I mean, when I got past the fact that she was wearing the pancakes on her booty on each cheek, I had to really look at her booty, and I'm just wondering, did she have some stuff inserted? I mean, something, you know, injected in the booty. Do y'all think that's her booty? I just don't remember Miss USA having all that ass. Anyway, y'all, this last episode right here was on some other levels. And the thing that killed me this last episode, they concentrated on the whole charity event or whatever when she came up in there with the booty pads for 2 seconds of the damn episode. So I can only imagine what next week's episode or this coming week's episode is going to be like. So I cannot wait to see it. But y'all got to let me know what y'all think down below. Let me know if you agree with any of what I said or if you know anything else or whatever. Hit me up down below. Leave your comments down below. I love checking them out. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Y'all know I'm here in town now, so I will definitely be doing these videos more often. As always, follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/socialitesandy. Hit me up on my Facebook fan page, that's down below. You can hit me up on Pinterest, and that link is also down below, as well as my blog, thesocialitelife.blogspot.com, as well as Instagram. I'm all over Instagram at socialitesandy. And you already know, I love y'all, and I will see y'all soon in the next video. Bye.
Your music.